Hello.
Hi.
This is Raj from EQ Music, and we are here with Dagny. How are you today?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Good. Here you are at British Summertime Festival today. Justin Bieber on the bill, Martin Garrix. How are you feeling about the show today?
I'm feeling good. I think we're excited to be playing this festival in general. Like, it was really like moment of like, woo, we got it. And it's a nice, I mean, the weather is amazing. Lots of great artists on stage. Unfortunately, we have to like rush off right after our show because we're playing another festival tonight. So it won't be too much time to like look around, but now we've had a few hours to just enjoy the sun and meeting some people and stuff.
Amazing.
So,
how is life on the road though? Because you've been touring quite a lot lately.
Yes, we're doing 33 festivals this summer.
Wow.
Which is quite like, yeah. And a lot of other stuff in between, obviously. So it's very hectic and busy, but I love it.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, get to travel around.
Yeah.
And we're doing a lot of festivals that are like really unique. Like in Norway, we're doing festivals that are up in the mountains.
Okay.
And, you know, out on like islands far out in the ocean and stuff, which is like taking my English band.
Yeah.
It's just like, oh my God, look. Look at
it's my country.
Yeah. So then I get really like proud of it. But yeah, it's really nice.
There is quite a unique buzz around what you're doing right now, and you know, with a lot of new artists, there's industry hype and there's fans talking and real true music fans talking. Mm-hmm. What's it feel like to, you know, have a record and a song out wearing nothing that's actually resonating with a lot of people these days?
I think for me that's the most important thing, because as you said, it's like you have the industry buzz and you have the fan buzz, I guess. And sometimes one comes before the other, and sometimes one comes but not the other. I mean, it changes. But I think for me, like, now playing shows and actually seeing people coming and like singing along and giving so much of themselves. As an artist, when you're on stage, it's like, for us at least, like, you know, you give, and then when you then get back, you can give so much more.
Uh-huh.
And so we've had some really amazing shows lately where you can see that people are like really connecting with the music and loving it. And I get so many nice like comments online and stuff. So yeah, it means a lot. I think it's, you know, that's what you want to do. You want people to connect and feel something.
Uh-huh.
And when you're sitting in the studio, you're not being able to like look at people and seeing how they react at the time.
Yeah.
So you kind of just have to trust your gut. And so it's obviously like quite a scary thing to release music and then see what people think. So it's been really amazing, this single coming out and now having people already like.
Yeah, it seems like every day I'm seeing a comment from one of my music friends going, oh Dagny,
great.
How come I haven't heard of this before? This is amazing. So there's actually, it really is buzzing. So it must be a great feeling.
Yeah, it's a very nice feeling.
Tell me about filming the Wearing Nothing video. I'm obsessed with all the choreography that you had to learn from it. So what was it like filming that day?
It was fun. It was really fun. Like, I normally get really awkward on camera. I'm like, oh my God. And then I'm just like, oh. But this particular one was just super relaxed and fun. And you know, Nathan and Ryan that I was dancing with, they were just like, they were actually dancers, so
yeah.
They knew what they were doing and could like kind of guide me and help me out a little bit. But a lot of the choreography was actually made on the spot, because we we ended up losing some of the time to prepare. So it was kind of like sitting at the table knowing that, like, okay, in 10 minutes we have to go, and then it's like do, you know, it's like fuck. But so it was a real challenge, and just like realizing how you move on camera versus how you feel like you're moving. So I think I learned a lot, and I really didn't want that day to end. It was so much fun.
Oh, amazing. Very cool. Thank you for sharing that. I love your collaboration with Bourne, Fool's Gold. What was it like recording that with him?
First of all, let me just say I'm a massive Bourne fan.
Yeah.
I really am.
Yeah.
I love his music, and I listen to it, and I can't wait for the new record.
Were you fangirling when you were...
I was actually a little bit fangirling. So it was when I realized that he was actually going to be on the track, I was like, oh my gosh.
Yeah.
But I've never actually met him.
Okay, yeah, it's one of those collaborations.
It's one of those like 2016-17 collaborations. So we have yet to meet. I'm hoping that one day he's just going to jump up on stage and suddenly just be there and just sing his part. It's going to be perfect. Nah. So, but Tommy English, who produced the track, he's working very close with Burns, and we've been working a lot together. So that's kind of how it all came about. And he's also amazing.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Dagny, it's been a pleasure talking to you today. Have a great performance.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
And we'll see you soon.
Absolutely.
All right.